So far, we have seen how to record your lecture content using a screencasting software like OBS. What we will see in this video is how to introduce pen as part of your lectures. Since often you may want to underline some bullets or write some notes when teaching. This pen support is in some sense independent of the recording software, because once you say start recording, it will record whatever is in that window or on the screen. And if the software you are using has a pen support and you start writing with that pen, the recording software will just capture that. So we will focus in this video on how do you enable pen and use it effectively in a given software. Before we dig in, there are certain requirements that have to be met. Bamboo tablet is a cheap alternative for you to be able to use pen. There isn't any installation that is required. If you just plug it into the USB port, it'll automatically, you can start using it. So it's basically a plug and play. With the bamboo tablet, you can write neatly and crisply, but this requires some practice. When you start out with words, your words may not look very nice. So for example, you may write something like this, but over time, you should be able to write nicely. So do spend some time practicing with the bamboo tablet till you are able to write well. You can also go for a more expensive option in the form of a touchscreen laptops with pen and stylus. The number of models available for this in Linux are very few, and it is not a straightforward setup. You have to install the required drivers, play around with it to finally make your pen work. I personally don't have any experience with touchscreen Linux laptops, but others have successfully tried them. What if you don't have either a bamboo tablet or a touchscreen laptop? You can still use the pen, where you can convert your slides into PDF and open them in Zernal, which is a software which we will see shortly. And once you open the up in journal, you can underline the text in the slides and explain, and your screen recording software like OBS will capture it. How do you underline? You can use the mouse function for this. You can just left click and then drag on the mouse pad to be able to underline. Adobe Reader also opens PDFs. It's very popular, but they have stopped Linux support, so we are not going to cover this. So we will use Journal, which is actually quite powerful. If you already have slides as PDF, we will see how to open it in Journal and enable pen support. We will see all these. Again, a demo is best. So let's see a demo now. So to open your slides in Journal, all you need to do is type Journal, name of the file, and an ampersand. It will open. One thing nice about Journal is all its functions are listed here in these two rows. So I have opened my slides. If I wish to navigate across my slides, this arrow is useful. This will take me to the next slide and next slide, and this will take me to the previous slide. This is how to navigate. Let's say at a given slide, I want to now lecture and at the same time underline some things. Let's assume I don't have a bamboo tablet. So for that, I'm going to use this pen tool. So I'm clicking on it. So as you can see, my cursor now has become a dot. This dot is black in color. This is its width. I can choose some other color. Let's say I'm going to choose green, and with this now I can underline with my mouse, where all I did was left click and dragged. So this way I can do underlining and explaining my slides. You could also potentially use text when explaining. In other words, even though you cannot write without a bamboo tablet, you can always type. So for that, this text is not a bad idea. So I'm choosing text. You should also be ready to choose a given size. So let me choose a slightly bigger size here. Let me go for size 20. Okay, and then I can type look below for some explanation. So you can do this type of writing on the slides when you are explaining your lectures. You could also use this highlight tool to highlight some portions. So again, here it is a little bit too narrow, so let me use this. So I can highlight like this some portion to show to the students to pay attention. Instead of underlining, I am highlighting here. Sometimes we make mistakes, in which case we need to correct them. So for example, I'm not happy with my highlighting and I want to remove this highlighting. So for this, I need to select this highlighter. For that, I'm going to use this rectangle select. So I'm going to do this. It's going to choose my highlighting and I'm going to press delete. So it has removed my highlighting. You could also delete with an eraser. So for that I am clicking this and I am deleting it with an eraser. I can also delete my underlines with an eraser. So that is the purpose of the eraser. In case I felt I made a mistake, I should not have deleted what I did. You can also use undo. This is the undo button. So here it showed back what I had deleted earlier. And this undo you can do any number of times to go back to the previous state. So this is also a useful feature. So this is how you correct your mistakes. You may also want to zoom in to certain portions of your slides when you are explaining to give better resolution. So for that you can use these zoom in. So when I do this, it's kind of taking me closer and I can also zoom out and accordingly explain. These are more or less the tools that can help when you are recording. After you are done with all this write-up, you definitely want to save. For that, you can click on save. So this is going to save all this inking. When I'm saving for the first time, it will ask me for its location, but this file I have already saved before. So let me do save as, and it shows a given folder. And as you can see, this file has a different extension, XOJ. This is how journal saves its files, because I may want to open it again, more annotation to it and so on. So you can definitely save like this, but when I share with my students, I definitely don't want to share a XOJ file. For that, I'm going to do file, export to PDF, give it a name, and I'm going to save. If I were to open it, it is opening the PDF. This is a PDF file. This is not a, this thing earlier is a XOJ file, whereas this is a PDF file, which I've still opened it with journal. So this, you can see the slides.